Hi all. This is the fourth lecture of the subject EC 303 Applied Electromagnetic Theory. We are continuing with module 4, which is transmission lines. So in this lecture, we are going to find out or derive the characteristic impedance of a transmission line. We are also going to find out how the characteristic impedance and other parameters will vary in different types of transmission lines. And then we are going to solve one or two problems regarding whatever equations that we have derived till now. So let's start with the characteristic impedance. So I just say CH impedance, which means characteristic impedance. We had derived previously that when there is a transmission line, you will be supplying some wave in terms of a voltage from a source through the transmission line to a load. So this is our transmission line. When you supply this voltage or this wave through the transmission line, we found that in the transmission line, there will be two types of wave. One is called as forward traveling wave, which will be attenuated as it travels along the direction of position. So if this is x equal to 0, this is x equal to L, where L is the length of transmission line. As the wave travels from x equal to 0 to position L, it will be a cosine wave, but it will be attenuated. So this wave which travels forward is called as forward traveling wave. Now, we also found that although there is a wave which travels forward, there is also a wave which travels backward. That means some wave will be of this form. Okay. So there is a backward traveling wave or reverse traveling wave. These two ways are totally independent. It is the final output at any point, or the final wave at any point of x, is a combination of these two waves. And we have seen the equation for V Z comma V of Z comma T also as the summation of two different attenuated cosine waves. Now, once you have in a circuit, you have a voltage, you will always ask, so what is the impedance of that circuit? So when a voltage wave is traveling through the circuit, it should impart some amount of current. And the ratio of voltage by current is the constant, which is either a resistance when it is completely real or impedance if it is a complex number. So similar to any circuit, the transmission line, in any transmission line, you should also need to find out what is the impedance of transmission line at any point. Suppose that you have some kind of an instrument like a multimeter or a voltmeter and an ammeter, where you place it in the transmission line and you can measure the voltage and current at any point of transmission line. If you divide voltage by current, you will get a value, which is the impedance. That impedance at any point of the transmission line is called as characteristic impedance. So I define characteristic impedance as the ratio of voltage and current at any point in a transmission line. So basically, this is also the impedance at any point in a transmission line. So one might ask, at any point in a transmission line, you will have both forward traveling wave and backward traveling wave. So FTWI say as forward traveling wave and BTWI say as backward traveling wave. So which wave should I take to measure my characteristic impedance? Because both waves have voltage and current. So for which waves voltage and current ratio will give me characteristic impedance? The answer is, you can take either one. There's a notation of characteristic impedance, which is denoted as Z suffix zero, Z zero. So this is actually the characteristic impedance. Okay. So I can define Z zero as the ratio of voltage and current, which is V zero plus by I zero plus. Because even if you take V Z comma T comma by I Z comma T for the forward traveling wave, then you see that both has cosine terms, because V Z comma T and I Z comma T will be of same form. It will get cancelled. E raised to minus alpha Z also will get cancelled, because it will be same for both voltage and current. So finally, you will end up only with this ratio. So we want to find out this ratio. Okay. We are going to derive the characteristic impedance. To derive that, we will make use of the equations that we have already seen, that is dvs by dz is equal to r plus j omega l into is. This is the equation that we have seen previously. And dis by dz is equal to g plus j omega c into vs. And we found that the solution of this equation is vs is equal to v0 plus e raised to minus gamma z plus v0 minus e raised to plus gamma z. Let's substitute this value in this equation. Okay, so I can write minus d by dz of v0 plus e raised to minus gamma z plus v0 minus e raised to plus gamma z is equal to r plus j omega l into is. And since Vs is of the form V0 plus e raised to minus gamma z plus V0 minus e raised to plus gamma z, my Is should also be of the same form, because the ratio of voltage and current should be some kind of a constant. It cannot depend on time or space. So my Is I can write as I plus e raised to minus gamma z plus I0 minus e raised to plus gamma z. So I have Vs and I have Is. So wherever we say about Vs, the Is is also of the same form in the entire transmission line. We can derive the same expression for Is using the same procedure as that we have used in Vs, but we will get this same equation. So in this equation also you have an Is term. So I can substitute this Is value here. So when I substitute the value, so let's do the differentiation here. So when you differentiate this, V0 plus is a constant, V0 minus is a constant. So both are constants. So when you differentiate, you will get minus V0 plus minus gamma e raised to minus gamma z plus V0 minus e raised to plus gamma z is equal to r plus j omega l into I0 plus e raised to minus gamma z plus I0 minus e raised to plus gamma z. So there is a gamma also here because we are differentiating with respect to gamma. So let's take the negative sign inside in the LHS part. So you'll get V0 plus gamma e raised to minus gamma z minus V0 minus e raised to plus gamma z into gamma is equal to R plus j omega l into I0 plus e raised to minus gamma z plus I0 minus e raised to plus gamma z. Now if you see this equation, there are terms of in both LHS and RHS, there are terms of forward traveling wave and backward traveling wave. For example, this and this are for forward traveling wave, and this and this are for reverse traveling wave or backward traveling wave. Now the forward traveling wave will not induce a current in the backward direction. Similarly, a backward traveling wave will not induce a current in the forward direction. So I can simply say that the I0 plus is caused by V0 plus and I0 minus is caused by V0 minus. And V0 plus cannot influence I0 minus. So they are totally independent. So I can separate the equations by equating only the terms of forward traveling wave or the terms of reverse traveling wave. So I can equate only the parameters of forward traveling wave or backward traveling wave. That means I can say V0 plus gamma e raised to minus gamma z equal to R plus j omega l into I0 plus e raised to minus gamma z. So I equate only those parameters or components of forward traveling wave, which is V0 plus gamma e raised to minus gamma z and R plus j omega l I0 plus e raised to minus gamma z. Also, I can also write for equate the components of reverse traveling wave, which is V0 minus e raised to gamma z into gamma, that is equal to R plus j omega l into I0 minus e raised to gamma z. Okay, so let's look at this forward traveling wave. Okay, so this is for forward traveling wave and this is for backward traveling wave. So let's look at the forward traveling wave equation. So it says V0 plus gamma e raised to minus gamma z is equal to R plus j omega l into I0 plus e raised to minus gamma z. So e raised to minus gamma z comes both in left hand side and right hand side, so it will get cancelled. I'll bring I0 plus to the denominator on the left hand side and I'll bring gamma to the denominator on the right hand side. So I'll have V0 plus by I0 plus is equal to R plus j omega l divided by gamma. Now we have already defined V0 plus by I0 plus as characteristic impedance. Okay, so this is the characteristic impedance. Let's expand this further. Z0 is R plus j omega l divided by gamma. We have seen in our previous lecture that it is root over R plus j omega l into g plus j omega c. So I can write this as root over R plus j omega l whole square divided by root over R plus j omega l into g plus j omega c. So you see, you can cancel the squared part and you will end up having Z0 is equal to, so this square will cancel and this R plus j omega l will cancel. So you will finally have Z0 is equal to square root of R plus j omega l divided by g plus j omega c. So this is Z0. which is our characteristic impedance. So this is a very important equation in which it shows that if you measure the value of impedance at any point on the transmission line, it depends on the line parameters R, L, G, and C, and the impedance will be complex. That means I can write this as some real term plus J into some imaginary term. So R0, you should not confuse with resistance. So this is actually the real part of Z0, and X0 is the imaginary part of X0. Okay. So what happens if you do for backward traveling wave? Let's see that. So for backward traveling wave, you have minus V0 e raised to minus gamma, sorry, plus gamma z into gamma is equal to R plus J omega L into I0, so this is V0 minus I0 minus e raised to plus gamma z. Again, you will cancel e raised to plus gamma z. So we'll have V0 minus by I0 minus is equal to R plus J omega L by gamma with a minus sign. So this is minus root over R plus J omega L by G plus J omega C. So my Z0 for reverse traveling wave is V0 minus by I0 minus, that is minus root over R plus J omega L by G plus J omega C. Okay, there is something weird in this equation. You see, R, L, G, and C are always positive. Omega is also always positive. So this term here, which is Z0, is always negative. The question will come, can an impedance be negative? The answer is no. Here the impedance value that you see is negative because in the transmission line, if you have a transmission line this like this, for a load, sorry, you have a source, you have a load, your direction of Z is in this direction. So here somewhere is Z equal to 0, here somewhere it is Z equal to L. Okay, but your wave is traveling in the opposite direction. So the wave traveling in the opposite direction sees the backward traveling wave, sees an impedance in its opposite direction. That is, the wave is traveling backwards, but the impedance is actually towards the front. So that direction change is the reason why Z0 is negative for backward traveling wave. Okay, so it is the wave experiences an impedance, but only because it is traveling in a direction opposite to the direction that we have chosen, it sees a negative impedance. Actually, the impedance value is positive. So that is a concept that you might need to understand. Okay, fine. So you have now got the equations for V0 plus by I0 plus, that is Z0. Also V0 minus by I0 minus, that is minus Z0, where Z0 is the characteristic impedance. So from this equation, what is I0 minus? This is V0 minus by Z0 with a minus sign. Similarly, from this equation, your value of I0 plus is equal to V0 plus by Z0. Let's go back to the equation of IS. So IS is I0 plus e raised to minus gamma z plus I0 minus e raised to plus gamma z. Let's substitute these two terms for our I0 minus, let's substitute it here, and I0 plus, let's substitute it here. So your equation for IS will be V0 plus by Z0 e raised to minus gamma Z minus V0 minus by Z0 e raised to plus gamma Z. So if you see this equation, you have represented everything in terms of V0 plus and V0 minus. Previously, when we had Vs also, which is V0 plus by, sorry, V0 plus e raised to minus gamma z plus V0 plus minus e raised to plus gamma z, you see there were like four variables, I0 plus, I0 minus, V0 plus, V0 minus. Here there are only two variables, which is V0 plus and V0 minus, and Z0 is common, so we can say there are three variables. With these three variables, you are able to represent the equation of voltage and current. So this is an important equation which we will regularly use in explaining and deriving many important concepts in transmission lines. So this is basically our characteristic impedance. Now let's move on to a different let's move on to how the transmission line looks like in a physical world. Basically, we are going to see when we use this equation in actual scenario, in which we are going to find the different types of transmission lines, and if you use this parameters in those scenarios, how will the parameters change? Okay, so the different types of transmission lines are, for example, coaxial cable. Before explaining coaxial cable, let me explain the general form of a transmission line. Physically, how does the transmission line looks like? Any transmission line has an outer conductor. Let's say this is your transmission line. Okay. So whatever is outside, that is this part, this part, this part, this is a conductor. Means it has conductivity, which I represent that sigma C, approximately equal to infinity. It's a heavy conductor, it will conduct electricity. But whatever is inside, whatever is inside, so this is a hollow conductor, But there is something inside. So this is basically a dielectric medium. Dielectric medium means some kind of a medium. An air is a dielectric medium. It can be an air, or it can be any of the dielectric medium inside the conductor. For a dielectric medium, the conductivity is approximately zero. Okay, you should not confuse the conductivity that is mentioned here. This conductivity is for electric conductivity. We are actually propagating a wave. So I should say this as electric conductivity. Doesn't mean that it will not conduct electromagnetic waves. It means that it can conduct electricity. A dielectric medium will be an ideal case in which it will conduct electromagnetic wave without any loss. So it is like perfect conductor for electromagnetic wave, but it is a bad conductor for electricity. So you should not confuse the conductivity that is mentioned here. Okay, so another, so the basic common type of conductor is, or transmission line, is a coaxial cable, where you have there is a middle, where you have a middle conductor, there is a conductor at the outside, and there is a dielectric medium at the in between them. So there is a dielectric medium here, and this is basically a conductor. Outside surface is a conductor, so as the one which is inside. This space between these two conductors is filled with dielectric medium. So whenever you want to transmit something through this cable, so what you will do is you have this cable. There is an inner conductor. And you will connect a source to this coaxial cable. So this is the source resistance, or we call a source in transmission lines as generators. That's why there is a G. It will deliver the power to some kind of a load. So we call the source in transmission line as generators. So this is the basic diagram in which you see that you have a generator which generates the electromagnetic wave. The generator have some amount of resistance associated with it. Through the resistance, the electromagnetic wave will propagate through the transmission line. So here the transmission line is coaxial cable. The coaxial cable will deliver the wave with some amount of attenuation to a load. Okay. So now thing is, we have already modeled the transmission line, right? So if I want to have zero attenuation, that the wave that I propagate should not attenuate, what should I do? We saw that V of z comma t is V0 plus e raised to minus alpha z cos of omega t minus beta z. This is for the forward traveling wave. Okay. Now, if I don't want any kind of attenuation, then my value of alpha should be 0. Then it will not attenuate. Or if you look at any kind of an electric circuit which has resistance, inductance, capacitance, etc., which is the component which actually reduces the voltage? That is basically the resistance, because inductance and capacitance stores energy and resistance dissipates energy. So if I want to reduce any kind of loss in a circuit, you should just exclude the resistance. Similarly, if I want to make the medium, if I want to make the transmission line lossless, that is, there is no loss of power, or in other ways you can say voltage, in the transmission line. Such a transmission line is called as lossless transmission line. In a lossless transmission line, the outer conductor is perfect, which means it doesn't have any types of resistance or conductance, because the dissipation of power is through only resistance and conductance. And the dielectric medium is also perfect, means the conductivity of dielectric medium is 0, the conductivity of outer conductor is infinity. So this is called as a lossless medium. So let's see how these parameters will change in a lossless medium. So in a lossless medium, my value of resistance is 0, value of conductance is 0. So my gamma is equal to root over R plus j omega L into G plus j omega C, which is equal to, just substitute R equal to 0 and G equal to 0. So this is root over j into j is minus 1, omega into omega, omega square into LC. So root over minus 1 is j. This is j omega root over LC. So the value of gamma in a lossless medium is j omega root over LC. So what do you see here? Gamma is alpha plus j beta, where alpha is the attenuation constant. We already told that if alpha is 0, then you don't have any kind of attenuation. So if you compare these two equations, you see that this equation doesn't have a real term. Implies the value of alpha is 0. It has only imaginary term. Implies the imaginary term beta is equal to omega into root over LC. So in a lossless medium, the attenuation constant is 0. The phase constant beta is omega root over LC. Okay. So what is the ratio omega by beta? Let's look at the ratio. Is there any significance on that? Omega by beta. Omega is 2 pi f. Beta, we have already told in the last class, it is 2 pi by lambda. So this is basically frequency into wavelength. What is frequency into wavelength? It is the velocity of light or velocity of the wave. So u is equal to omega by beta is the velocity of the wave. So can we find an expression for velocity of the wave in terms of r, l, and c? Yes, we can, because we already know beta is equal to omega root lc. So if I do beta by omega, it is equal to root lc, implies omega by beta is equal to root l, sorry, omega by beta will be equal to 1 by root lc, that is the velocity of the wave. So in a lossless transmission line, there will not be an attenuation. Okay, so there will not be an attenuation because alpha is equal to 0. There will be a phase constant, which is omega beta, which is equal to omega root lc. The velocity of the wave is given by u is equal to omega by beta, which is 1 by root lc, which gives the velocity. Now let's talk about one more type of line, which is called as distortionless line. Now, any signal will always contain some range of frequencies, okay? And if the signal, when it is passing through some circuit, if the circuit amplifies the different frequency values by different gains, then we say that the signal is distorted. Okay, so whenever a signal is passed through a circuit, if the circuit amplifies or attenuates, it can also be an attenuation, the different frequencies by different levels, then it is called as distortion. So I define distortion as wave amplitude of different frequency components will be attenuated differently. This is called as distortion. The main reason for distortion is, so this is basically caused by frequency dependency of alpha. So if alpha is frequency dependent, then there will be distortion. So what should we do to make sure there is no distortion? So for distortionless line, there are two conditions. One, alpha, which is the attenuation constant, should be independent of frequency And two, there is one more condition actually. The phase constant beta should be linearly dependent on frequency. If these two condition is satisfied, then we say that line is distortionless. So under what condition will these two condition will get satisfied? The condition is the ratio of resistance and inductance should be equal to the ratio of conductance and capacitance. So the condition for a distortionless line is the ratio of resistance and inductance should be equal to the ratio of conductance and capacitance. So once we have defined that, okay, this is what we need for a distortionless line, let's see how the gamma, which is called as propagation constant, and attenuation constant and phase constant has its values. So gamma again is root over R plus j omega L into G plus j omega C, which is equal to root over, I am taking R from this and G from here, so I get R into G into, or let me just write one more step, R into 1 plus j omega L by R, so that if I take R inside, we'll have R plus j omega L. G into 1 plus j omega C by G. So that if I take G inside, this term, it will be G plus j omega C. This is root over RG. I take G and R common into root over 1 plus j omega L by R into 1 plus j omega C by G. So gamma is equal to root over RG. You see, L by R and G by C are same. L by R is equal to C by G, sorry, because it is from this condition. So both are same, so I can either substitute L by R as C by G, or I can substitute L by C by G as L by R. So I'm just going to substitute L by R as C by G, or the other way, C by G as L by R. So I can write this as root over 1 plus j omega C by G whole square. So this is equal to root over RG into 1 plus j omega C by G. So this gamma is equal to root over RG plus j omega root over RG into C by G. So this is root over RG plus j omega so root g divided by g will you have root g in the denominator and c into root over r by g. Okay. So this again can be written as so r by g is L by C, which is from the condition, So this is root over Rg plus j omega into C into root over L by C, that is root over Rg plus j omega root over L into C. Okay. So in this gamma, your real part is this and imaginary part is this. So you can say the value of alpha is equal to root over Rg, the value of beta is equal to omega root over Lc. So these are the expressions for alpha and beta in distortionless transmission. You see, alpha is independent of frequency, and beta is linearly dependent of frequency. Okay. And you will have the value of the velocity u is equal to omega by beta, which is again that is equal to 1 by root over Lc. There is one more term that we can find out, which is the characteristic impedance. Z0 is equal to square root of R plus j omega L by g plus j omega C. This is root over, just take R from the numerator out, so it will be R into 1 plus j omega L by R divided by, let's take g from the denominator out, so it is 1 plus j omega C by g. So you see L by R and g by L are same. So this and this are same. So you can, it will cancel out, and finally you will get Z0 is equal to root over R by G. So R by G is also equal to root over L by C. So your Z0, which is the characteristic impedance, is equal to root over L by C, which is equal to root over R by G. So this is characteristic impedance. And you see the characteristic impedance is purely real or it is resistive. Okay. So I think I missed one point in lossless transmission line. In lossless transmission line also, you can derive the expression for Z0, which is equal to root over R plus j omega L by g plus j omega C. Now R is 0, g is 0, so you will get Z0 as root over L by C, which gives that the characteristic impedance of a lossless transmission line is purely real. Okay, so these are the derivations that we have considered for different types of medium. So if we recap again, then we see that there is a characteristic impedance for any transmission line, which is the ratio of the voltage and current at any point in a transmission line, which is called as impedance at any point in transmission line. So at any point, the forward traveling wave, which I called as FTW, and reverse backward traveling wave or reverse traveling wave, which called as BTW, has a ratio of its voltage and current, which is the characteristic impedance. We derive the ratio of the voltage and current to be root over R plus j omega L by जी प्लस जे ओमेगा सी, विच इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, विच मीन्स इट हैज अ रियल पार्ट एंड अ इमेजिनरी पार्ट. फॉर बैकवर्ड ट्रैवलिंग वेव वी फाउंड दैट इट इज नेगेटिव वैल्यू, इट इज जस्ट बिकॉज द डायरेक्शन दैट वी टेक इज ऑपोजिट. वी फाउंड दैट यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट द करंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ वी जीरो प्लस एंड वी जीरो माइनस एंड सेट जीरो. And in general, transmission lines in general have a conductor outside and there is a dielectric medium inside. The conductor should be perfect. The dielectric medium should have conductivity zero. It doesn't mean it is, it means only that the electric conductivity is zero, but the electromagnetic waves can still propagate. And then we found there are two different types of medium, which is lossless medium. So the condition for lossless medium is R equal to zero, G equal to zero. And we found the expressions for gamma. So gamma is called as propagation constant. Okay. So we found the expression for gamma. We found the expression for alpha, beta, and the velocity. We also found the expression for the characteristic impedance of lossless line. Similarly, there is distortionless line, and the condition for distortionless line is R by L is equal to G by C. And we found the expressions for gamma, alpha, beta, velocity, and characteristic impedance for the distortionless line also. I think this will give you a good idea of how the wave behaves in different transmission lines. So I think we'll stop it here. Please go through the lectures and notes. Let me know if you have any questions. Thank you.